On behalf of Principal Julio Contreras and the faculty and staff, welcome to DCIS Montbello's virtual 2020 8th grade continuation ceremony. The poet E.E. Cummings once said, "It takes courage to grow up and become who you really are." But why is courage involved? First of all, you have courageously persevered to the end of middle school, despite all the changes that have occurred this past semester due to the COVID virus. You have shown that DCISM students never give up. But growing up is also a journey filled with new beginnings, and each new beginning brings a unique set of challenges which require courageous action. 3 years ago, you were beginning your middle school journey, and during the subsequent years, it has taken courage for you to master ever more complex ideas, to develop compassionate and meaningful relationships, and to accept greater and greater responsibilities. As a result, today you are at the top of your game, having become everything you could be in middle school. Now it will be time for you to experience another new beginning this fall that will require courage on your part, being a high school student. So your teachers would like to share a few memories and their words of wisdom to help you navigate a new type of school with different people, different opportunities, and different expectations.
Oh, this is Mr. Barty. One of my favorite moments this year was when my students were working extremely hard to learn and study the U.S. Constitution. The day after the exam, they really wanted to know what their scores were, which made me very proud as a teacher. And they all did well, by the way. My advice to you all as you enter high school is to work very hard and study in all of your classes. And also, if you can, play a sport, join a club, or get a part-time job to keep yourself busy, to learn more about responsibility and teamwork, and all the things that are going to help you become a successful adult. I wish you all the best of luck.
Hi, this is Mrs. DeSelms. My favorite memory this year's is actually a series of moments and time spent making art with all my students, and having meaningful conversations with my classes and with individuals. Every single one of you is special to me. I miss walking through the hallways, getting hugs, high fives, and hearing, "Hey, Miss D," or "Hey, Miss." I really do miss it all. My advice to you as you enter high school is to be persistent, self-advocate, and recognize that trying is better than opting out. That is how we learn. After all, as Bob Ross said, and say it with me, we don't make mistakes, we have happy accidents.
Greetings and salutations. This is Mr. Dupuy. Thank you all for making my first year at DCIS memorable. From the kindness you showed in class to the jokes that made me laugh, I will always remember this eighth grade crew. I'd say my favorite memory from class this year was when we did the mock trials. I love seeing you all embrace your roles in the mock courtroom. It was fun for me to play the judge while you played prosecutors and defense lawyers and witnesses and the jury. It was something that I thought was a lot of fun. My advice to you as you enter high school is to be vulnerable. It's okay to try new things. It's okay to befriend new people. It's okay to fail as long as you pick yourself up and get right back to it. Not every experience will be perfect or happy, but they will build your character. High school is a time of growth. Whatever your path brings, remember, the force will be with you, always.
Hi, this is Ms. Lozano. First of all, congratulations. This year, everything has been new for me, as well as for some of you. New country, new school, new students. In spite of some of you have been learning more math than others, all of you are special for me, because you have been learning at the same time I was learning also. In the future, I recommend you to try the best every day, to work hard, and this is the way of achieve your goals. And good luck.
Hola, soy Miss Lozano. Primero de todo, enhorabuena. Este año muchas cosas han sido nuevas para mí, igual que para muchos de vosotros. Nuevo país, nuevo colegio, nuevos estudiantes. Y a pesar de que algunos de vosotros habéis aprendido más matemáticas que otros, pero todos habéis sido especiales para mí este año, porque además habéis estado aprendiendo a la vez que yo también estaba aprendiendo. Para el futuro, os recomiendo trabajar duro cada día. Todos los días intentar hacer lo posible para conseguir vuestros objetivos. Trabajando duro es como se consiguen los objetivos. Y con buena suerte.
Hi everyone. This is your math teacher, Mr. Wu. Your middle school is over. It's so strange we have to celebrate your continuation this way, right? And just be proud of yourself and be proud of what you have done with me, with your eighth grade. And next year you will be high school students. The best memory I remember is when I show you all the interim 3 test. I was so proud. The whole school was proud of you. And I can see you guys are so happy with your result. That's really a good year for me. And I think for most of you are also a really productive year for you. Again, as your math teacher, math is logic and math is reasoning. So I want you to understand, without practice, without understanding, you cannot do math. Also remember, I am your teacher. The most important, I am your friend. Remember, I will be always here if you need help with math or even personal things. Okay. Thank you for giving me the opportunity to serve you, to help you. See you soon. Bye.
Hi, 8th grade. This is Mrs. Eidler. Congratulations on your continuation. One of my favorite memories with you guys this school year was celebrating at the end of semester celebration in December. It was really cool just to hang out outside of the classroom. My advice to you going into high school is don't be afraid to ask for support when you need it, whether it's from a teacher, a counselor, maybe it's another student. We're all here because we care about you, so don't be afraid to reach out. Congratulations, and I hope to see you around next school year.
Hi, rising 9th grade students. It's Jada Blackwell. Some of my favorite memories from this year have been going to the middle school soccer and football games. It was great to see the teamwork and camaraderie and joy you guys had on the field. I'm happy I made it to all the games that I did. Another really great memory was some of the 8th grade girls putting on a dance performance in the intro to culture class in celebration of Black History Month. You ladies killed it. One piece of advice that I have for you as you go into high school is to try new things and take risks. So meet new friends and sign up for new clubs and try out different classes that really might be interesting for you. Congratulations again. I'm so proud of you all.
Hey guys, Mr. Bubis here. Hope you're doing well during quarantine. Hope you're staying safe, taking care of yourself and your families. We just ended the year. Amazing. Feels like it went like that. Thank you for a wonderful year, wonderful introduction year for myself to Colorado. Thank you for giving it your all. I know you're going to do great things in high school as you move forward in your education. I want you to remember, though, my advice to you is that you continue to participate because you all have so much to offer, so much experience, so much knowledge, but we, the teachers, won't know what you have to offer unless you participate. So thank you, take care, and I hope to see you in the hallways next year. Have a great summer. Bye-bye.
Bonjour, it's Mr. Dixon. Telling you guys a little bit about my favorite memories of my first year teaching at DCIS Montbello. Definitely the stories. A lot of good stories from you guys, hearing about stories from your families and about your experiences in different countries, and also seeing your reactions when I tell you my experiences in my different countries that I've been in. That's definitely my favorite part, as well as just getting to know each and every one of you. Feel really lucky to have been able to do that. Now, here's some advice going forward. I know it sounds cliche, but just be yourself. I know it's really hard to do that. You always want to just kind of follow what your friends are wanting to do, or you see a celebrity and you try to emulate what they're doing. But be yourself. Set your own goals and follow them. Stick with it. And you can do whatever you want. Good luck next year. And remember, I'm always there if you ever need any help or have any questions or just want to talk. Bonne chance. Au revoir.
Hola, por acá Miss Bustamante, maestra de Latinos in Action. Un momento memorable durante el año escolar fue cuando elegimos los comités y los líderes de cada grupo a inicio de año escolar. Y cada uno de los momentos en que los estudiantes brindaron su colaboración a las familias de DCIS Montbello en las actividades de la escuela. Estos momentos fueron sin duda cuando ellos más brillaron. Mi consejo para ti cuando entres a high school es sé tú mismo. Y sé responsable, no dejes que otros te depriman. Trata de concentrarte más en el trabajo y en la escuela, además de los amigos. Middle school solo te prepara para el high school. High school te prepara para la universidad. La universidad te prepara para ese trabajo de tu vida. Entonces, cada escuela te lleva a algo más alto para alcanzar tus metas. La educación vale más de lo que tú piensas. Ve a la escuela todos los días y gana tus créditos. Esos créditos son tu camino al éxito.
Hello, this is Jenny Benavides. My favorite part from this school year was when I threw a party during Christmas with my students, and many of them brought a lot of food from their country, and everybody had a good time, and we were able to play a lot of games. Like flipping cup and some games with like ping pong. We played with balloons. It was just a lot of fun to have many students be there and enjoy some time, good time together. My advice for you now that you're going to high school would be that always be yourself, stay true to yourself, and enjoy as much as you can of all the classes that you are going to have. Work hard to have good grades. Remember that this is your next step now that before you go to college. Your teachers are gonna be preparing you for that. So try to keep that in mind. And also take your time deciding the career you're gonna pick. You have some years before you make that big decision. So. Try to choose something that you're going to love doing.
Hey, eighth graders, this is Mr. Schultz here. Congratulations on continuing on to high school. I've had many of you since you were in sixth grade, and it's been really fun to see you guys learn and grow over these past couple years. My advice to you all in high school is to go to class, do your work, and to learn something new every day. Again, congratulations on continuing on to high school, and I'll see you guys next year. Thank you.
Congratulations, eighth graders and eighth grade families. I'm Mr. Frank. I teach ninth grade math and one section of eighth grade math. My best memory of the year is that this was my first year teaching eighth grade, and I couldn't have asked for a better group of hardworking, thoughtful students who have really pushed my thinking. I will never forget them. My advice for ninth grade would be to choose to be successful. Acknowledge when you need help and ask questions. The ninth grade team is here for you. We want you to be successful, and we will do whatever we can to make sure that you get the education you deserve. Have a great summer. I look forward to seeing you over the course of the next 4 years.
Thank you for that introduction. I'm Alicia DeSelms, and I am the art teacher. Let me begin by welcoming all of you to today's online event, and a big thank you to Dr. Coogan and every eighth grade teacher and Mr. Contreras for making this ceremony possible. I also want to thank our eighth grade students for the years of dedication to get to this point in your academic journey and for perseverance you have demonstrated during these recent weeks in quarantine. I'm very pleased to have been invited to speak on what is, I know, a very special day. This is special for students, for their proud parents and grandparents, and for their teachers. Just wait until these students are graduating high school and college. I know from experience that the time will go fast, and my hope is that all of you go to the next level of education, ready to tackle any obstacle that comes your way. Today is one of those great occasions when we get to celebrate our young people, their achievements, their perseverance, and their success as they grow up. It's one of the times you can take a break and reflect, feeling good as a parent or a mentor, knowing that the kids that you care about are doing just fine and they're on the right path. Students, you should know that your mom and dads are very proud of you today. They have high hopes for you and they believe in you, and you are making them proud by showing what you can do. Take a look at them now and you can see them smiling, snapping photos so they can record this moment forever. Today is an important day for you and for them. Today, they are very, very, very proud of you. Today would also be a good day to hug them and thank them for supporting you, because as much as this is your achievement, this is also the achievement of the people who care about you. That means your mom, your dad, your stepmom, your stepdad, your grandparents, your sisters, your brothers, and all the people who care about you. They want you to be your best and live up to your potential. Continuations can be seen as a coming of age, a sort of official way to recognize when a person steps into the next stage of life. And students, you are stepping into a new stage. The teenage years of high school are here and waiting for you to crush it, thrive, and prepare yourselves for other stages. With every year, you have become a little more independent. I bet you can still remember your first day here. It might have been exciting and a little intimidating too. But when you look at the sixth graders going to class, you might think, wow, they look so little. I can't believe I was ever that young. Get used to it. You'll be thinking that for the rest of your life. But when you see younger students, you can tell how much you've grown up, how much you've learned, and how much you've matured. Think back on some of the exciting things that happened this year, all the things you've learned. This year, you have learned to meet expectations, be authentic, and most of all, persevere. You have persevered through snow days, coursework, and most of all, online learning. If you can hang tight through this, you can achieve anything. I have faith in you. You have some great times this year, and maybe you had some tough times this year, but you did it and you succeeded. You're ready for the next step. I ask you, as you prepare for this next step, to do a few things. First, stop and think about what you want to achieve in the next 4 years. Set short and long-term goals to keep you on track. Secondly, I ask you to take this chance to dedicate yourself to making your ninth grade year even better. Remember that you don't have to follow the crowd. Do the right thing, even if no one is looking. Study hard and remember that you're investing in yourself with every test you take and every book you read. And finally, don't be in too big of a hurry to grow up. These are some great times in your life, so don't rush past them. Be your authentic self. There are great things coming, and just as your parents are proud, each one of you should feel proud of yourself. So congratulations to all of our students. Congratulations to the parents. And finally, congratulations to the teachers and everyone else who helped get our students here today. I'll leave you with this final quote from a great author with whom I imagine you are all familiar with, by the name of Dr. Seuss. You have brains in your head. You have feet in your shoes. You can steer yourself in any direction you choose. You're on your own, and you know what you know. You are the guy who'll decide where to go. Congratulations again, eighth graders. Please know that I love and I miss you terribly. Thank you very much.
Good evening, eighth grade class. Welcome to continuation. Congratulations. Felicidades. You've made it. For those of you who don't know me, my name is Mr. Dupuy. This year, I had the privilege of teaching eighth grade U.S. history. I have the honor this evening of speaking to a fine group of learners and their wonderful families. This is my first year teaching at DCIS, and what a year it's been. None of us could have known at the start of the year what fortune had in store for us. Thinking back at the beginning of the year, I'll admit, I was nervous.
As any person in a new place, I was nerve-wracked, wondering and worrying about all the little things that teachers worry about. What is the best way to teach history? Who will my students be? What can I teach them? And then the first day came and I met you all. I soon learned that I had very little to be nervous about. You were all kind and welcoming. Some days I felt I learned more from you than you learned from me. In class, you shared hopes and dreams. I learned that you wanted to be engineers, game designers, rappers, and so much more. When we encountered injustice in history, you spoke out. When those injustices persisted throughout history, you shared your righteous indignation. You spoke candidly about a world that you wished to see. One where racism and sexism were not the default, where people were judged, as Dr. King notes, by the content of their character and not the color of their skin. I enjoyed all these experiences with you. I enjoyed seeing you land the perfect three-pointer or quarterback and receive an excellent play. You also taught me to love Takis and extra hot Cheetos, even if I wasn't so thrilled you were eating them in the middle of class. I thought a lot about what I wanted to say about the end of this year. With a year full of so many moments, it seems unfair to focus on something that has kept us apart, kept us from celebrating your achievements in person tonight. You did not ask, nor did you expect, that a global pandemic would consume our society. Yet you all stepped up. Families who have faced unprecedented challenges supported you, and you supported them by finishing the year strong, all while handling extra tasks at home. You did not seek, nor were you prepared, to become online learners overnight. Yet you have tried your hardest and succeeded at mastering online platforms of learning while maintaining the connections that allow learning to thrive. I've known college freshmen devastated by responsibility of learning on their own. Here you are showing that the eighth graders of DCIS can handle anything. Even with this crazy year under your belts, you may be nervous about the year ahead. That's okay. As I noted above, everyone gets nervous about starting something new. It's okay to be vulnerable. It's okay to feel overwhelmed. It's okay to make mistakes. It can be hard to go from being at the top of the middle school pyramid to being at the bottom of the high school one. Yet I know that you all have what it takes not only to survive, but to thrive in high school. With hard work and a positive mindset, your future is within reach. I want to leave you with a quote from one of my favorite characters in history, Bobby Kennedy. Bobby, who is the brother of President John F. Kennedy, often said, "Some men see things as they are and ask why. I dream of things that never were and ask why not." I've always liked this quote. It speaks to the boundless optimism of the future. It is okay to be sad now. It is okay to weep for the moments you lost. Months of hanging out in person with friends, sports seasons lost, even this celebration that you and your families desperately wished were in person. I and your teachers miss the days we could have spent learning with you. But after that sadness and anger passes, it will be time to dream once more. It will be time to set your gaze on the horizon and let your hearts wander, dancing to the melody of tomorrow. It will be time once again to ask, why not? When that time comes, you will find your path is boundless, your dreams are attainable, and the future is yours. I wish you the best on the journey ahead.
It is my pleasure to introduce Mr. Dupuis, Mr. Bubis, Ms. Blackwell, Ms. Wilson, Ms. Benavides, and Ms. DeSelms, who will present the DCIS Montbello 8th grade class.
Andres Alcantar. Michael Alcantara Guerrero. Yasmin Ali. Neda Almeida Perez. Jose Altamirano. Tajay Alvardo. Gustavo Amaro Cortez. Omariante Anderson. Christian Arvizu Aguilar. Mauricio Avalos Burisiaga. Rosada Avila Iboa. Sandra Avila Soriano. Alan Ayala Ereves. Saul Azua. Ariana Ballesteros. Rodrigo Bonuelos. Jose Batres. Alejandro Bencomo Rodriguez. Alexis Bustos Ramirez. Luis Calel Pol. Jason Canales Rodriguez. Jose Cardona Morales. Oscar Carreno Arambula.
Samantha Chaparro. Raldi Chicon Lora. Irandi Concha Alvarez. Kiledi Dianduakila. Hector Diaz Hernandez. Giselle Diostados Garcia. Ruby Escalante Aguinaga. Isidro Escalante Rodriguez. Albert Espino. Brenda Estevez Lopez. Vanessa Fernandez Perez. Leticia Flores. Jasmine Flores Godinez. Charlene Flores Sayang. Kaya Fountain. Shalinta Francisco. Edith Garcia. Yadalyn Garcia Hernandez. Josue Garcia Padilla. Juan Garcia Roa. Edgar Garcia Salazar. Jonathan Giron Garcia. Josiah Gonzalez. Armando Gonzalez Banuelos. Valeria Gonzalez Sandoval.
Ivan Granados Leo. Julio Guerrero. Alfredo Guzman Gonzalez. Kevin Guzman Santos. Tariana Hall. Jabari Harris. BJ Hazard. Ashley Herr. Abigail Hernandez. Tony Hernandez. Giovanni Jojo Hernandez. Palma Herrera Lopez. Duran Herzl. Charisma Hunt. Johnny Iglesias Huerta. Brittany Jaimez Maldonado. Leslie Jaquez Marquez. Elena Jimenez. David Jimenez Garcia. Leonardo Leo Jimenez Gomez. Marlene Jimenez Lopez. Francois Capinga. Jeremiah Lewis. Zyra Lewis. Louise Lopez.
Freddie Lorenzo Juan. Aaron Loivano. Josue Macias. Jasmine Madeira. Tammy Mahmoud. Zadeh Marin. Dorian Martinez. Jason Martinez. Sitlali Martinez Algarate. Jorge Martinez Cabral. Yazira Martinez Dominguez. Angel Martinez Galvan, Angel Martinez Maldonado, Tanya Martinez Martinez, Lorelli Martinez Mendez, Javier Martinez Razo, Jimena Martinez Razo, Samantha Mendez Alvarez, Melvin Menjivar Hernandez, Luis Meza Bonilla, Jared Mier Flores, Roderick Monge Flamenco, Daniel Morales, Evelyn Morales, Mariana Morones Salas, Kelvin Munoz Adame,
América Muñoz Jiménez, Daniel Murillo Rivera, Nora Namdrick, William Nielsen, Max Ojeda Ramírez, José Ortega Santos, Emanuel Pacas Mundo, Angelina Pacheco, Carlitos Palacios, Yaretzi Palacios Barraza, Brian Palomar Molinar, Astrid Pérez, Eulogio Pérez, Carlos Pérez Ruiz, Román Porter, Elías Ramírez Amaro, George Ramírez Amaro, Ana Ramírez Pérez, Marisol Ramírez Serrano, Mario Ramírez Tobar, Maritza Reyes Madrigal, Natalie Rodríguez, Xavier Rodríguez, Salvador Rodríguez Pina, Miguel Rodríguez Torales, Andrew Román Jaime,
Gilberto Romero, Alexis Ruiz Gonzalez, Ernesto Saldana Morales, Nelson Sanchez Fuentes, Monique Swarmley, Jada Spiller, Ginevra Teles, Vanessa Torres Castillo, Amarami Torres Fuentes, Annette Torres Iglesias, Jordi Trevino, Arlene Vasio, Angel Valdez, Carlos Valdez Flores, Luis Viejo, Adonis Viejos, Lizzy Vasquez, Maria Venegas Sosa, David Villanueva Quiñones, Cody Viegas, Nicole Viegas Gutierrez, Nikesia Ware, John William, Javier Zamarapa,
estimados padres de familia, maestros, miembros comunitarios y estudiantes. Dear parents, teachers, community members and students. Quiero darles una calurosa bienvenida a todos ustedes a nuestra celebración de continuación virtual esta tarde. La continuación es una tradición en nuestra escuela y quiero expresarles la importancia de esta ceremonia, pues estamos celebrando los logros de nuestros estudiantes de octavo grado. We are celebrating continuation, which is a tradition in our school that brings us together in celebration of our eighth grade students at DCIS at Montbello. I want to thank all the eighth grade teachers, all the counselors, and all the interventionists that have made it possible for us to celebrate our eighth graders at the end of this school year and welcome them into high school in ninth grade. So what are we celebrating today? We are celebrating the accomplishments of our eighth grade class this school year, the effort and dedication that our students have demonstrated through hard work and academic achievement, as well as participation in clubs, sports, and other school events that have demonstrated their leadership skill and have demonstrated that they are ready for the big challenge of high school, beginning with the ninth grade. Our mission at DCIS at Montbello states that our school's aim is to prepare our students to the challenges ahead by helping all our students master their social and academic skills needed to be successful as citizens of the world in the 21st century. As ninth graders, I know that our students will begin this mission and have numerous accomplishments during their high school career. We want our students to be successful and accomplish their dreams by going to different areas in the professional world, including four-year colleges and as well as two-year colleges, and accomplish their careers, their dreams through education. We know that our parents in our community value education, and so we will support our parents and continue that strong bond with our parents to make sure our students are successful. This is why I wish to welcome the class of 2024 into ninth grade. I wish to remind all our eighth graders that as they begin their high school career at DCIS at Montbello next school year, that they need to remember the following points. You did not get here by yourself. It takes dedicated parents. It takes dedicated family members, teachers, and administrators and counselors to work together with you to achieve your dreams. Remember this, because in high school, you will need all this help even more. And we want you to feel free to ask for that help, to ask for that support, because remember that we will make it together. And we will make sure that not only you graduate from high school, but that you have the opportunity to go further into the field of education, further into your professional dreams, and make sure that you have all the things that you deserve. Be thankful that there are people that care for you and support you every day. There are also people in your community that care for you. Do not forget them and go and say hello, because you will need them again. Gracias, padres de familia, y a toda la familia que apoya a los muchachos, porque han trabajado juntos para alentarlos, apoyarlos, y han luchado para que sus hijos tengan el mejor futuro posible. Seguiremos ese compromiso con sus hijos cuando entren a high school. Also remember your past and present teachers who work to provide you the knowledge and motivation to keep learning and exploring the wonders of science, math, literature, world languages, the arts, humanities. All these are fields that will help you in the future. All these disciplines are an important part of who you are and who you are going to become in society. So thank your teachers for the love they share with you through their labor. Gracias, maestros, por todo el esfuerzo y el amor que le han dedicado a cada uno de sus estudiantes. Gracias. I also want to especially thank Ms. Alicia DeSelms, who has spent countless hours working with our eighth graders and motivating them to finish strong. Gracias, Señora DeSelms. I want to also thank all our eighth grade teachers who have worked together as a team to reinforce the value of education, the value of hard work in making sure that our eighth graders move into ninth grade with all the skills that they need to be successful in high school. Finally, to you students, I want to thank you for all the hard work you have demonstrated for the sleepless nights that you have sacrificed to study for your tests, for coming to class every day, for listening to your teachers, for following your parents' advice, for being punctual to class, for being respectful to your friends and teachers, and for believing in yourself, for supporting each other, and for celebrating our accomplishments. Please continue finding ways to improve and never quitting in your effort to reach the full potential that you possess. I will take the liberty to give you a few recommendations for next year as you begin your ninth grade in August. Remember, ninth grade is a crucial grade in your high school career. It is the first year of your high school career, so make sure you start right and you make strong relationships with your teachers and ask questions. Make sure that you maintain your grades high because that is going to be your initial grade point average for your high school career. Remember, we are here to support you. Enjoy your summer. Rest and find healthy and safe ways to spend your leisure time. Make sure to read books. Make sure to talk with your family members and learn new things through the wonderful world of internet. When you start your high school career in August, meet one of your teachers and ask your teacher to give you advice on how to go to college and how to study to be successful. Befriend a teacher. During the school year, do not procrastinate and do not wait until the last minute to study. You have incredible skills and we want you to do your best and reach to your dreams because you can do it. And lastly, do not miss school. Come every day. We are ready and eager to have you back and we want you to be back with energy and with that desire to learn new things. Build as many friendships as you can, get involved in clubs, and by all means, enjoy and have fun in school because school is fun. And so we are waiting for you here in August. I wish you the best. Enjoy your summer. Parents, muchas gracias por el apoyo que recibimos por parte de ustedes. Vamos a trabajar juntos por apoyar a sus hijos y celebrar este momento especial que se llama la celebración de continuación, ya que sus hijos lo merecen. Muchísimas gracias.